We're not set up for communion today, so we'll have communion next Sunday instead of today. Also, like to call your attention to the music and worship committee meeting, and that's going to be tomorrow night at 6:30, June 7th at 6:30, and then the annual conference for the Association of Free Lutheran Congregations is coming up June 16th through the 19th, and that's just up in Plymouth at the Bible College out of Medicine Lake, and would encourage you to go to some of the sessions, if not all of them, or even at the evening worship services, you would find them delightful. So, and then the council meeting for the church is going to be at 6 o'clock, June 17th. Let's begin today with prayers. Jesus, you have promised us rest because of your finished work on the cross. And I pray that today, as we think about it, and even as we leave the sanctuary, walk out into the world around us, that over and over we might say today, I can rest in peace because of what Jesus has done for me. And Lord, today I pray that we might worship you in spirit and in truth. Send your Holy Spirit in each one of our hearts. Help us to set aside the cares and the worries, the excitements and expectations of the world around us, and to worship you. We ask all of this in Jesus' name. Amen.
In our first hymn, My Faith Is Found in the Rest.
Thank you.
This time I'm going to ask that we would confess our sins before the Lord. And we're going to have a time of silent confession. And following that, then we'll hear the Word of God speaking to us about our sins. Lord God, I thank you that you have promised us over and over in your word that we can have our sins forgiven by what you did on the cross. And I thank you for the promise in 1 John 1:9, where it simply says, if we confess our sins, you are faithful and just and will forgive us our sins and purify us from all unrighteousness. How can we ever thank you enough for that? In Jesus' name. Amen. This time we're going to call on Isaac for scripture lessons.
Moses sent them to spy out the land of Canaan and said to them, go up into the Negev and go up into the hill country and see what the land is and whether the people who dwell in it are strong or weak, whether they are few or many, and whether the land that they dwell in is good or bad, and whether the cities that they dwell in are camps or strongholds, and whether the land is rich or poor, and whether there are trees in it or not. Be of good courage and bring some of the fruit of the land. Now the time was the season of the first ripe grapes. So they went up and spied out the land from the wilderness of Zin to Rehob near Lebo Hamah. They went up into the Negev and came to Hebron, Ahiman, Sheshai, and Talmai. The descendants of Anak were there. Hebron was built 7 years before his home in Egypt. And they came to the valley of Eshcol, and cut down from there a branch with a single cluster of grapes, and they carried it on a pole between the two of them, and they also brought some pomegranates and figs. That place was called the Valley of Eshcol because of the cluster that the people of Israel cut down from there. At the end of 40 days, they returned from spying out the land, and they came to Moses and Aaron and to all the congregation of the people of Israel in the wilderness of Paran at Kadesh. They brought back word to them and to all the congregation, and showed them the fruit of the land. And they told him, We came to the land to which you sent us. It flows with milk and honey, and this is its fruit. However, the people who dwell in the land are strong, and the cities are fortified and very large. And besides, we saw the descendants of Anak there. The Amalekites dwell in the land of the Negev. The Hittites, the Jebusites, and the Amorites dwell in the hill country. And the Canaanites dwell by the sea and along the Jordan. But Caleb quieted the people before Moses and said, let us go up at once and occupy it, for we are able to overcome it. Then the men who had gone up with him said, we are not able to go up against the people, for they are stronger than we are. So they brought to the people of Israel a bad report of the land they had spied out, saying, the land through which we have gone to spy out is a land that devours its inhabitants, and all the people that we saw in it of our great height. And there we saw the Nephilim, the sons of Anak, who come from the Nephilim, and we seemed to ourselves like grasshoppers, and so we seemed to them. The second scripture reading comes from the New Testament book of Hebrews, Hebrews chapter 3, verses 7 through 19. Hebrews chapter 3, verses 7 through 19. Therefore, as the Holy Spirit says, today, if you hear his voice, do not harden your hearts as in the rebellion on the day of testing in the wilderness, where your fathers put me to the test and saw my works for 40 years. Therefore, I was provoked with that generation and said, they always go astray in their heart. They have not known my ways. As I swore in my wrath, they shall not enter my rest. Take care, brothers, lest there be in any of you an evil, unbelieving heart leading you to fall away from the living God. But exhort one another every day, as long as it is called today, that none of you may be hardened by the deceitfulness of sin. For we have come to share in Christ, if indeed we hold our original confidence firm to the end. As it is said, today, if you hear his voice, do not harden your hearts as in the rebellion. For who were those who heard and yet rebelled? Was it not all those who left Egypt led by Moses? And with whom was he provoked for 40 years? Was it not with those who sinned, whose bodies fell in the wilderness? And to whom did he swear that they would not enter his rest, but to those who were disobedient? So we see that they were unable to enter because of unbelief. Here ends the scripture readings.
Thank you, Isaac. This time we're going to have prayer time, and if you have prayer requests that you'd like to